What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you how to create an easy lower third animation in Adobe Premiere Pro. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create a lower third in Adobe Premiere Pro 2021, and also how to animate that lower third and create a motion graphics template out of it. Alright guys, so let's go ahead and dive in. As always, you can download this motion graphics template for free by clicking the link right there in the description. It's the first line. Go ahead and click on that, submit your information, and you'll get it as a free download right to your inbox. Okay, so right here you can see I have a project open. I have a sequence with just an image of me. I'm just going to create my own lower third, and we're going to do it all through the Essential Graphics panel, okay? So to start, let's make sure we have the Essential Graphics panel open, as I do. So if you don't have it, hit Window and then go all the way down to Essential Graphics and click this on. Next, we are going to create a shape, okay? So I'm going to create a rectangle. I'm going to make it kind of thin. You can see it over here on my screen. I'm going to move this anchor point to go right in the middle of it too. And I'm going to change the fill to like a deep red. There we go. Okay, and I want to make it a lower third too, so I'm going to make sure I turn on my safe margins, because this will show me where the general vicinity of where lower third should be. So I'm just going to drag it down here. So now what I want to do is I want to make this rectangle kind of like fade on and rotate to introduce the text. So I'm going to go ahead and do that animation real quick. Let's go into the Effect Controls panel. If you don't have that open, you can just go into Window up here. Okay, and let's bring this down, and what I want to do is I want to do a mask. So from the very beginning, I'm going to create just the mask, right? So this mask reveals it, okay? So I'm going to put it below, okay? And I'm going to hit the stopwatch on the mask path, and I'm going to go over about 12 frames. So I'm going to hold shift to the right twice, that goes over 10 frames, and then hit right twice. Again, now I'm at 12 frames, okay? And then I'm going to put another keyframe, but this keyframe, as I click on the mask here, is going to represent me revealing it. So I'm going to pull the mask up, and it's just going to reveal the rectangle, okay? Okay, so now we have the rectangle fading on. Bam, okay? So let's go to that point again, 12 frames in, and let's do a little rotation. So I'm going to go down by the transform, and I'm going to hit the stopwatch for rotation. I'm going to go shift, right, right, and then let go of shift, hit right, right. So now I'm 12 frames over, and I'm going to do negative 30 degrees, okay? So it goes from 0 to negative 30. Bam. Okay, but I want it to kind of like snap. So I'm going to have it ease out. And I'm going to go into the rotation graph editor by hitting this little drop down arrow next to it. And I'm going to zoom in on the velocity section. Okay, and see this little handle here? I'm just going to pull it to the right. So it just kind of like shoots out. Ready? Okay, so I just want it to like snap. Right? Right when it snaps is when I want the text to pop on, okay? So let's minimize all of this. Bada bing, minimize the shape. Shape's all good. And let's do some text, okay? So I'm gonna put Sam Peretti, change the font to the way I like it. Okay, and then let me go ahead and take my selection tool and let's move this over. I'm gonna add a little drop shadow to it. There we go. Okay, let me go ahead and duplicate this text. Control C, Control V. And I'm going to write my little subtext. So founder of ParEdits. Bada bing, select all. Let's change this text. Just doing some little things here, right? Just making it look nice. And I know the background is white, so it makes it tough, but it can work with any of your images. Okay, so now let's make this text kind of fade out from that little shape, okay? So I'm gonna put this shape on top of that text, and then I'm going to create another shape. Right, so here's another rectangle. I'm gonna make this, let's do negative 30 degrees. Okay, and then let's just kind of pull it out here. I'm gonna line it up with the other shape, okay? And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to mask with shape, okay? And I'm gonna invert it. So now that our shape is masking, it's removing anything inside of that shape path, okay? It's removing anything and making it transparent. So let's move this down below shape one. Shape one is our little tiny rectangle. And let's have it on top of our text, because our text is what we want to come in from nothing, right? So let's go ahead and animate our text now. First thing that we're gonna do is we are going to make sure we're at the right point in time. So this is gonna happen after our little rotation stops, right? Which is at, I think it's at exactly 1 second. Okay, so then let's go to the position of our name tag, and let's set a keyframe there. Let's go shift to the right. Okay, 12 frames over, set another keyframe because that's where I want it to be, and then let's pull this behind, right? See how it disappears? It's because of that mask. It's pretty amazing. And then let's have this, you know, ease out and ease in. Okay, so we did that for the name, right? All right, and then we will also do it for the subtitle. Okay, so let's see what we just did. Ooh, beautiful. All right, so now I'm gonna make it go back out, okay? So I'm gonna basically reverse the whole animation. So see how everything stops at 2 seconds, right? I want it to last a second, and then I want it to go away. So let's go ahead and do the reverse animation. So the last thing that came on should be the first thing to go. So let's go ahead and add a keyframe for position, and I'm going to just add all the keyframes to make everything reverse. It's basically everything we just did, but you know, reversed. So let me do that real quick. Okay, so I just reversed all the animations. You can see it because it's kind of like a cascading staircase, right? So right here, this is the mask that this reveals the line, and then these keyframes, this is the rotation for the line to rotate, and then these keyframes, these little circles, are for the text to just slide out. That's the subtext right under there. Subtext slides out, lasts for a second, subtext goes back in, name goes back in, rotate, and fade off. Yeah? What do you guys think? Look at this. Bam, 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 bam. Okay, I hope you guys like this. This video was a lot of fun to make. You can always download this as a free template. You don't have to make it yourself. I made this for you. Just download it, drop it into Premiere Pro. I have instructions on the page that I send you to. So go ahead and do that for yourself. And also, feel free to join the YouTube Motion Graphics Academy waitlist. It's a giant academy with courses and a bunch of free resources for you guys to join and use. And I'm building that right now, so join the waitlist right now. There's a link in the description. And on top of that, I'm also doing one-on-one tutoring, so if you haven't heard about that, that's in the description as well, so find that link. And last I want to leave you guys with is this video. It is a motion graphic subscribe button video. Please check it out. It's animated. It's amazing. You'll get a free download, so check that out too, and I will see you guys in the next one.